Hi, this is Vishwanath. I welcome you all to the fourth lecture in the module on Code of Ethics in Engineering under the certificate course in Life Skills for Engineers. Let's have a quick recap of the lecture 3. A brief introduction to applied ethics and engineering as a profession was given in the last lecture. We also dealt with ethics in engineering and its significance. In today's lecture, we will understand in detail what code of ethics in engineering are, their significance and its evolution. We have seen that one of the features of a profession is dedicated councils, societies of professionals. These councils or societies come up with code of ethics for its members. As engineering professionals, it is important for you to be aware and adhere to these codes. These codes may differ from one society or council to the other or from one country to the other. It depends on the area of work and the discipline being dealt with. So, what is the code of ethics? Code of ethics is a formal set of rules or principles. In other words, code of ethics contain ethical principles that govern the engineering profession. It is like a convention between the professionals to act in a certain way. It acts as a guide to the engineers so as to do and what not to do as engineering professionals. Now let us understand who makes these codes of ethics. Friends, these codes are introduced by the professional societies or councils of each profession. For engineering, the national and international engineering councils, societies have their own set of codes. With the increasing professionalism and the growing demands, the code of ethics is being regularly amended and updated. For instance, the National Society for Professional Engineers in USA, the Engineering Council of India, etc., have their own codes of ethics. You may ask a question here, but why code of ethics? Let us see. We may have 6 or 7 attributes. What makes code of ethics in engineering significant? The code of ethics are important for us to understanding the moral responsibilities of engineers. In addition, some of the other aspects that signify the code of ethics are: 1. The code of ethics acts as a commitment by the professionals that engineering will work for serving and protecting the public through their products and processes. 2. The code of ethics guides the engineers in terms of the responsibilities as engineers. 3. It acts as an inspiration and motivation as a member of a profession that is committed to promoting public good. 4. Through shared standards, the code of ethics helps in providing a fair platform while competing for the clients. 5. They support the engineers in taking a stand on most important moral issues. 6. These codes can be applied to cases in engineering which can facilitate increased knowledge and mutual understanding. Another important aspect of code of ethics is that it helps in deterrence and discipline. This is very important. This means it can be a very useful tool in monitoring unethical behavior. Finally, the code of ethics helps in building a positive image in the public. This is very useful in building and continuing trust in the public. Very important point. Hence, the code of ethics is very important for identification and supporting of professional values. Now, let us have a look at the evolution of code of ethics in engineering. Where and how did the code of ethics in engineering begin? Let us have a look at the history. The early history of adopting of code of ethics can be traced back to the code of Hammurabi in 1758 BC in Babylon. It's as old as that, as ancient as that. It had severe penalties for builders or architects who violated the codes. It attempted to bring in good engineering through this code. Very interesting. Dates back 1758 BC. But if you look at the modern day's code of ethics, it is a different story. In the beginning, these codes include standard business practices. With the increasing professionalism and the growing demands, the code of ethics is being regularly amended and updated. In engineering, the first code of ethics for engineers came into being only towards the late 19th century and early 20th century across the world. In fact, the code of ethics by engineering bodies came as a response to some significant structural failures that happened during that time, which include Ashtabula River Railroad disaster in the United States in 1876. This derailment because of the bridge collapse killing 92 people. Another one, Tay Bridge disaster in Scotland in 1879, collapse of a rail bridge killing more than 50 in a train. Quebec Bridge collapse in Canada was the other one, which collapsed twice, killing around 88 people. And Boston molasses disaster in the United States in 1919, a large molasses storage tank burst and molasses flowed at a great speed through the street, killing around 21 and injuring around 50. One major reason for all these incidents is the problem with the design and its erection construction. Eventually, as engineers and engineering emerged as a profession and as a response to development in the field, code of ethics were developed by various professional bodies of engineering. In 1912, the American Institute of Electrical Engineers adopted a code of ethics. In 1914, American Society of Mechanical Engineers adopted the AIEE code with minor amendments. The American Institute of Consulting Engineers, the American Institute of Chemical Engineers, and American Society of Civil Engineers brought in their own codes. By the year 1915, almost every major engineering body in the US had a code of ethics. Very interesting. In 1946, the National Society of Professional Engineers, NSPE, in the United States released canons of ethics for engineers and rules of professional conduct, which we'll be dealing with, very, very important. In 1964, NSPC adopted the code of ethics built on canons of ethics for engineers and rules of professional conduct. Let's have a look at the scenario of engineering societies in India and how they correlate with the ethics. In 1920, the Institution of Engineers were established and incorporated by Royal Charter in 1935. This is the first major code in India under the umbrella of Institute of Engineers. One of the services include inculcating and promoting amongst engineers and technologists a growing commitment to the social objective of the profession. The Indian Society of Engineers started functioning in 1934 to advance manpower development in the field of engineering, science and technology. The Engineering Council of India is another society which came up in 2002. It was established to work for the advancement of engineering profession in various disciplines while focusing on quality and accountability of engineers. What did these engineering codes of ethics contain? Let us look at the code of ethics of National Society of Professional Engineers as an example. It majorly contains a preamble, the fundamental canons, rules of practice and professional obligations. Preamble. The preamble, which emphasizes on significance of the engineering profession, reads like this. Engineering is an important and learned profession. Students and practicing engineers, please listen this to very carefully. Engineering is an important and learned profession. As members of this profession, engineers are expected to exhibit the highest standards of honesty and integrity. Engineers have a direct and vital impact on the quality of life of all the people. Accordingly, the services provided by engineers require honesty, impartiality, fairness, and equity, and must be dedicated to the protection of the public health, safety, and welfare, and I will add environment. Engineers must perform under a standard of professional behavior that requires adherence to the highest principles of ethical conduct. It stresses that the engineers must perform under a standard of professional behavior that requires adherence to the highest principles of ethical conduct. Let us see NSPC's fundamental canons. In the first part, it provides fundamental canons which are as you can see it. It says engineers in the fulfillment of the professional duties shall hold paramount the safety, health and welfare of the public. 2, perform services only in areas of competence. Very, very important. We have seen many examples in which engineers have been deployed in areas in which they are not competent or not suitable. Due to this, instances have come in the reports that the failures have happened almost 60 to 70%, where because of the time pressure, because of the commitments made to someone, these engineers were deployed and they were pressurized to clear certain aspects on quality or on completion, and where there have been failures. 3, issue public statements only in an objective and truthful manner. And nowadays, particularly in the digital world, where one WhatsApp message reaches from New Zealand to US within seconds and to large populations, statements made irresponsibly create havoc in the public. This is the area which is very, very important to note. 4, act for each employer or client as faithful agents or trustees, because some things have been designed with a lot of thorough knowledge and also planning. Everyone acting on their own will also create issues when it is come to implementation. Avoid deceptive acts. This is another area where promising more than what they can deliver or trying to play to the gallery. I think avoiding the deceptive acts by engineers is another act of unethical behavior. 6, conduct themselves honorably, responsibly, ethically and lawfully so as to enhance the honor, reputation and usefulness of the profession. Although we won't go to greater details, let's just have a look at the rules of practice and professional obligations. Engineers should hold paramount the safety, health and welfare of the public. Engineers shall perform in services only in the areas of their competence. Engineers shall issue public statements only in an objective and truthful manner. Engineers shall act for each employer or client as faithful agents. Engineers shall avoid duplicate acts. I am repeating because this is very, very important for every engineer to be guided. Code of Ethics for NSPC Professional Obligations. Always be guided in all the relations by their highest standards of honesty and integrity. At all times, strive to serve the public interest. Avoid all conduct or practice that deceive the public. Not disclose without consent any confidential information concerning the business affairs or technical processes of any present or former client or employer or public body on which they serve. There are numerous examples which in the references we have given. Just because of this reason, number 4, the IPR rights of some of the major global companies was lost and public interest litigations were filed, and global companies overnight they had to be shut down because of such unethical behaviors by their employees. Next, engineers are not to be influenced in their professional duties by conflicting interest. Very, very important, which many of you, particularly practice engineers, will correlate this, the conflicting interest of whether to complete the project exactly as per the deadline, which itself has been fixed, not based on any intelligence or importance, but from the political point of view or many other reasons point of view. I think we need not be influenced. You have to apply your professional knowledge and clear those things. Few of the examples which have been referred correlate to this particular area. In fact, in US, in one of the shuttle launch, the engineer was told to behave like a manager and not look the project like an engineer. The poor fellow who from the engineering knowledge point of view did not want to clear that particular step, after listening to his bosses that he should behave like a manager to keep the deadline, he cleared that particular step, which resulted in blasting and fire of the Voyager. 6. Not attempt to obtain employment or advancement or professional engagement by untruthfully criticizing other engineers or by other important or questionable methods. This is one of the most important things when you are working with large groups. 7. Not attempt to injure maliciously or falsely, directly or indirectly, the professional reputation, prospects, practices or employment of other engineers. Engineers who believe others are guilty or unethical or illegal practices shall present such information to the proper authority for action, which can be termed as whistleblowing in our parlance. Next, accept personal responsibility for their professional activities, provided however that engineers may seek indemnification for services arising out of their practice for other than gross negligence, where the engineer's interest cannot otherwise be protected. And lastly, give credit for engineering work to those who credit is due and will recognize the proprietary interest of others. Till now, we have seen the code of ethics, the evolution of the codes in the international context. In the next lecture, you will see how these codes of ethics and how they have evolved in the Indian context. Thank you.